Our next item of business, we do have a recognition that, gentlemen, if we could just come up front of the podium. And Rodney Cates, if you'd come down and bring all the guys from EMS that's with you.
Come around up here.
So we have some special recognition to make tonight to some people for some heroic actions, and I'm going to tell you what happened, then I'm going to tell you how all these people play a role in it and why it worked like it did and how it worked like it did. In the early morning hours of 11/27/21, which was just about a week ago, Medic 2, who was Major Anthony Vick in our white shirt here, and EMT Joel Fullerton, this gentleman standing right here, the other members, some of them are not here. EMT Tristan Sparks is here. Logan Booth is actually on a truck tonight, and I'm assuming was not able to make it at this time. They responded to a call of a residential structure fire, and it was reported that one person was trapped inside of the residence. The Medic 2 crew, and they arrived on scene first, and the Medic 3 crew arrived there shortly after. But how does this happen? What, these two people in the blue shirts, how does this happen? How did they know to get there, and how did they know to get there quickly? Well, they know to get there quickly because of the work of a 911 telecommunicators, and how they process the call, the speed at which they process the call is how they get there. Miranda Anderson was the call taker. The person dialed 911, she actually answered the call. She's got five processes that she has to do. Number one, she answers the phone, Rockingham County 911, what's the address of your emergency? So she can capture the address. By standard, her second statement is, give me your address again to make sure I have it correct. Her third thing is to say, tell me exactly what's going on. When she says, tell me exactly what's going on, she puts a nature code into the computer system, which then drops into a dispatch queue, of which Sean Farmer picks it up at that point to dispatch the call. So I don't know how long it took me to describe that to you, but it took them 17 seconds to do that night. Wow. From the time the 911 call came in until the first dispatch went out was 17 seconds. That's pretty quick. That's how lives are saved. That's how these people can get on scene and make those life-saving efforts. So tonight, as we go through this, Miranda Anderson, you are recognized for your outstanding achievement for your life-saving efforts that were displayed on 27 November 2021. Your certificate, Sean Farmer. Yours, which reads the same. And in emergency services, we give out life-saving tokens, and I think the county has something for you as well. For the people that have not seen these life-saving tokens, they start out as a flat line, which means no heartbeat, which means death. They turn it into the heartbeat or the EKG, which shows the heartbeat. So you took a situation which was potentially a deathly situation that night, and you turned it into a subject that's still alive today. So great job. So then what happens once they get on scene? Paramedic Anthony Vick, who is a major and a supervisor, he and Logan Booth, who is not here, they get on scene, and they're able to visually make contact with the subject who is in the front room of the residence. Fire department was not on scene yet. They were on the way. They knew they had to make forcible entry into the residence. Paramedic Booth and Paramedic Vick then made forcible entry to remove the subject from inside of the burning home. Once they had him out, paramedic or EMT Fullerton and EMT Sparks assisted with the evacuation of the person that was inside the home to an area where care could be initiated for the people. There was already another person who had been trapped inside the fire. They had gotten themselves out, so we really have two patients at this time. Paramedic Booth and the other EMS members placed themselves in harm's way and undoubtedly saved the lives of the occupants. The fire was quickly engulfing the room in which the subject was located. Had EMS crews not taken the immediate action they did, the man would have certainly not survived. So, Major Anthony Vick, life-saving certificate. EMT Joel Fullerton, and EMT Tristan Sparks. And with those, your life-saving tokens as well. And in conclusion, I'm going to use the words that Major Vic sent to me because I think he summarizes this quite well. He sent me an email capturing this, and I already had known about it through our situational updates, but Major Vic writes, "These types of calls are the calls you remember for the duration of your career and beyond. The members involved in this call displayed acts of heroism above and beyond their normal call of duty and made split-second decisions when a citizen's life hung in balance. Actions such as these represent the highest standards of emergency services and demonstrate the courage, determination, and selflessness that make emergency services great. I commend each of you for a job well done. Thank you."
On behalf of your Board of Commissioners, we have an award as well, a certificate of recognition for Anthony Vick.
Thanks, sir.
Again, thank you. Joel Fullerton. Thank you. Miranda Anderson. Thank you. Tristan Sparks. Thank you. Sean Farmer. Thank you. And Mr. Booth is not here. Logan Booth is not here. I'll let you have that, Mr. Cates.
And these folks know what county they're working in. It's written on their paychecks, and it's written on their uniform. But in addition to that, your commissioners would like to give you this pen to remind you that you're in a good place. And thank you on behalf of all of us and all the citizens of this county.